Hi, my name is Ben Cross. I'm the founder and lead developer at Heartstrings Studios, and today we're celebrating 10,000 subscribers on YouTube with some updates, some new information, and what to expect from us over the next couple of months. Before we get into the updates, I just want to say a quick thank you to everyone who subscribed to the channel, followed us on social media, joined us on Discord, and even reached out directly to talk about the game. We're hard at work getting things going, and we just recently were able to bring on some of our team members full-time, which will only help to speed up the process. So expect to see a lot more updates more frequently, and again, thank you to everyone that's helped us to get where we are. 10,000 subscribers on YouTube is amazing, and we're all very thrilled to see the outpouring of love for our game. So what have we been up to at Heartstrings Studios? Well, actually quite a bit. With our art team, Phil has been working hard to create new sprites, templates, and animations, and we've begun to test hand-drawn normal maps on the characters to allow for better shadows and lighting. The results so far have been great, and we're working on a process to help speed up the generation of these normals for any sprites that we create in the future. We also recently hired on a new sprite artist, JC, who's helping us currently build parts for the NPC library to allow for easier NPC generation. Kat has also been working on touching up some of the character art. We both felt that some changes to the facial structure would benefit the characters, and so far we're both very happy with the results. She's also been working on finishing up some characters that were still in need of a redesign from the old art. The one I think was most exciting for us to see was the redesign of Cyan, and while we appreciate the prior artist's work on the character, she desperately needed a better design to match the direction that we were going. We've begun taking the characters that were not yet completed from their sketch and line art phases to their full completion, and we'll have more that you'll be able to see over the next coming months. In the music department, Tom and I have begun working on the full main suite for Witch. This is a piece that we knew we had to get right, and after hours of discussing ideas, sending music back and forth, and determining the direction we want to go, we feel extremely confident and excited with how it sounds. We've even plotted out an opening cinematic for it that, if we can make it happen, should give a great introduction to the game, the world it's set in, and Vithica's past leading up to the fateful battle at the start of the game. In the gameplay department, we began plotting out skill grids for the characters. This definitely has a place in RPGs, and we feel that it will fit well within the world of Witch. There are individual grids for each Witch, allowing you to unlock new skills, buffs, abilities, stat increases, as well as some other options that may be specific to each individual character. Currently, our plan is to have magic skill points gained in three different ways: magic usage, leveling up, and tomes. In the world of Witch, magic becomes more powerful the more you use it, expanding your knowledge and control over the spells and abilities being used. Even passive abilities like Vithica's charges, Ren's summons, and Cyan's floromancy can grant skill points as long as their abilities are still utilizing MP. As well, you'll gain additional points for magic when you level up, or through magic tomes, which you may find as rewards for quests, random items from missions, or from a specialized building that you may be able to create in your city. That way, you're able to build up even more points to spend and expand the abilities of your witches without being limited to simply grinding away in combat. Another part of combat that we're really excited to work on is team-up attacks, where two witches will combine their magic and skills into powerful new spell combinations, deadly, overpowered attacks, and even create unique gadgets, buffs, and more. The original idea was to allow players to perform a team-up attack on a character's turn and then select who they were teaming up with. As long as both characters have the necessary MP and weren't hindered from using their abilities, they would perform their combined attack. This would give us the chance to create 28 team-up abilities throughout the entire 8-person main character crew. But then we began to question what would happen if we changed things a bit. Instead of focusing solely on what two characters would do together, regardless of whose turn it was, what if we instead had the character whose turn it is be the attacker, and then another is chosen as a support? This idea led us to the realization that we could expand both the number and the types of team-up attacks. For instance, if Maddie is the attacker and Pumpkin is the support, Pumpkin may use her fire to superheat Maddie's hammer before she brings it down on an enemy, dealing massive damage and leaving them burned. However, if Pumpkin is the attacker and Maddie is the support, Maddie may throw a gadget out onto the field and Pumpkin charges it with her fire, causing it to spray all enemies with flames every turn. This increases our number of team-up attacks from a possible 28 to 56, allowing even more possibilities for personality between the characters and the way that they work together, as well as offering the player even more opportunity and option with how they choose to play and what they choose to do in battle. Finally, we've also begun to focus more on city building, one of the major mechanics in the game. I could do an entire video on this part of the game alone, but I'll wait until we're a bit further into development to show what we have in mind, as there is a lot to show with it. I will say at the least that our team is hard at work testing things and implementing things as we can. Normally, at this point, I'd say thank you on behalf of all of us from Heartstrings Studios. And again, I am thankful for every one of you, all 10,000 plus that have joined us here. But instead, I want to take this time to say, please be safe. There's a lot of things happening in the world right now that are affecting a lot of people, including us. And it's easy to be angry, confused, scared, or depressed. But if you can, try and be safe and take care of yourself. We'll see you in the next video.